purpose of my talk, and I promise you I'm going to be brief, but I just wanted to give some idea. A lot of times people think with UK being in Lexington, big city and everything else, that you come to the animal science program at UK, there's not an opportunity for hands-on and actually working with livestock and all. And so wanted to at least give kind of an overview of what we do in the animal science, getting an animal science degree, and particularly those things that pertain to getting some hands-on experience and things like that. And so have a few things listed. There's quite a few classes where we do actually work with animals, or at least get to handle aspects of the animal anyway, biologically and all. So even the first year, the domestic animal biology and intro to livestock and poultry, those two classes do have some labs associated with them. Now those are typically fairly large classes, so there's not a lot of true hands-on, but certainly a lot of demonstration and things like that where students get the opportunity to see how different practices are done, and maybe even, I think in one of the classes, they even get to handle some reproductive tracts and things like that. So there are some opportunities there. The reproductive phys class, that's the when you start getting heavy duty into the reproduction aspects of it. And in that class, Dr. Bridges, in the past, they've been able to get out to the dairy to be able to do some ultrasound, demonstrate some ultrasound work out there and show them both open and pregnant cows. Our dairy situation is a little in flux right now, but hopefully in the future, we'll be able to re-implement some of that with that class. The block and bridle, a little international, that gives students an opportunity to show either a sheep or cattle, and the beef unit out here works with those guys as well. And actually, that's just kind of an opportunity to try and break an animal and show it in an actual show type setting. The big one is the last one, and that's our senior level beef production class. And with that one, I guarantee you, by the time you leave, you won't complain about not at least getting the opportunity to be able to do most everything hands-on with beef cattle that you would want to do. Not all students take advantage of that, but the ones that want to, we give them ample opportunity. The part I want to really emphasize there, and we're really fortunate. I'll put it this way. When COVID hit and we had to rearrange things, that was last semester of 2020, in the fall, we had to rearrange things because how we used to do our labs and our hands-on was we went out to a lot of farms here locally. And we would have the producers talk to us, and that was really good to give students that perspective from real producers out there in the real world doing things. But there weren't many opportunities for them to actually do it themselves. And so we had to readjust. And when we did, we tried to make the class much more interactive. So all the labs are out here at the farm now. Dr. Coffey was willing to work with us, and he purchased some steers for us. We wanted to do a backgrounding project. So he allowed us to purchase some calves, some feeder calves at the market, bring them in. And we so they come in at the beginning of the semester. We feed them all the way through, do all the processing of those calves. We have a nice ear tag system, electronic, the cow manager system, so where we can keep all the data up on them. And so we go through that. We go through the implanting process. We do all of that with these calves, and the students track them all the way through. And then at the very end of the semester, we take a tour out at Bluegrass Stockyards on a sale day, on a Monday sale day, and we actually get to, we work with Jim Akers, and he sets it up to where those calves sell while our students are out there, so they actually get to see the calves they worked with all semester sell in that sale. We also work with Kirk Van Zandt, the manager out here, and now he holds back some steer or some bull calves for us. And so the students are able to process those bull calves, castrating them. Now, we don't implant those calves because of research obligations that we can't do that with those calves, but they do get to castrate them. We get to go through ear tagging, so they get to vaccinate, deworm, all of those type practices, hands-on and in-person. The one you see there, and that's actually our students from this year, and that was the repro lab that Dr. Anderson does. Students get the opportunity to preg check some cows. They also get the opportunity to practice their AI skills and pass a rod on some cows as well. And so any and everything that we feel that a person might, working on a farm, have the opportunity to do, we try and expose them to that and give them the opportunity in this class. The one I don't have up there that I also want to let you know about is that if you're into livestock judging, we also have an active livestock judging program. That opportunity is there as well. And if you do join the evaluation or take the evaluation class that's associated with that team, you get those opportunities to go with that. There you get to go out to a lot of outside farms, judge cattle, and even we go to various contests across the country in the years that they can build up enough students to actually form a team. The department has been very supportive of that as well, and sending those young adults on those trips. So does anybody have any questions about what goes on here in animal sciences from a student perspective? Yes, sir.
How do those opportunities compare to maybe other universities in the area that our students would?
I can't hardly speak for them because I don't know how much opportunities, but I'll tell you this. If you go through our complete program, taking these courses that are up there, including the beef class, I can't imagine anybody is offering more opportunities. And particularly the one where we have the feeder calf project, as far as I know, that's unique in the country in terms of bringing in calves and having that be a part of that project all the way through. That was a project that Dr. Lim Cooler came up with and kind of conceived and we put into place that, like I say, as far as I know, is unique in the country.